This is a video that I've not made in a few years, and it's a video that I always get excited about. It is my Christmas shopping guide for the 2020 season. Now, if you guys are anything like me, you never know what to ask for Christmas, or if you're shopping for someone that's a fisherman, these are some good ideas or good gifts that they'll actually enjoy. From stocking stuffers to accessories to baits and lures and some higher end gear, these are some things you can ask for or buy for your fishermen in your life that they will actually enjoy. Now, as an introduction to the channel, if you guys don't know who I am, my name is Benjamin Nowak, and this channel here is a smallmouth experience, smallmouth bass fishing focused YouTube channel. So if you guys enjoy seeing smallmouth bass fishing content, you guys enjoy seeing big bass being caught, please do me a huge favor and hit that subscribe button down below. Let's grow this community. Let's keep this thing rolling and make this thing as big as we possibly can. Now, without further ado, let's kind of dive into this thing. So the way I have this set up, I have lures, baits, and gear, bass fishing directly related on my right side or on your left. And then on this side, I have some accessories, some things you guys might need that aren't necessarily baits or rods or reels. So the first thing we're gonna talk about are soft plastics. And if you guys have been living under a rock and haven't heard of Powerbait Max Scent, in particular the flatworm, for the smallmouth fishermen in your life, or if you guys are a smallmouth fisherman and haven't heard of this, you guys are missing the boat. This bait here has been probably the most coveted bass bait over the past 6 or 8 months since those guys made the Northern Swing. And what this is a little drop shot style plastic. It can be used for a Ned rig, on the back of a hair jig. This can be used for so many different things, but it is a smallmouth catching bait. This catches so many fish. And the power of this thing is in the Max Scent technology. This is the Berkeley flatworm. It's gonna be really, really difficult to find. In fact, this is the last flatworm that I have in the boat. But if you guys are looking for a bait that your fishermen will absolutely love and get really, really excited about, and you can find a pack of Max Scent flatworms, they are going to go insane. These flatworms are awesome. The Max Scent technology draws fish, especially smallmouth, that are very scent oriented from a long ways away. And this is probably one of my most highly rated products if you're looking for a bait to buy or a bait to ask for Christmas. Another product from Max Scent that I think is kind of overlooked and in that same sort of category is the Berkeley Hitworm. Now, out of the pack, what you're gonna say is it looks very similar to the flatworm. This is actually the bait that got me hooked on Max Scent. This is the bait that I started using on my drop shot that I really fell in love with, and then I learned about the flatworm and the powers of the flatworm. But this is a phenomenal bait. It can be used on a shaky head, can be used on a Ned rig. There's just a lot of really versatile applications for this, and it gets overlooked, so it's gonna be a lot easier to find. So if you can't find the flatworm and are looking for something that they'll also enjoy, the Hitworm is a great product. Now, my recommended colors would be like brown back in the flatworm, or green pumpkin, or just some of those more natural greens and more bait fish oriented styles of colors. But Max Scent products, in particular, the flatworm and hitworm, would be my most recommended soft plastic baits. Another product that I've thrown a ton over the past few years and really, really had a ton of confidence in is the Z-Man Elastec TRD ticklers. So I'm assuming most of you guys have heard of Ned rigging, but this is one of my favorite Ned rig plastics. And the reason for that are these little tentacles on the back of the bait. I feel like this gives that bait just a little bit more action than your standard TRD style worm, which is basically just a solid like turd looking bait. And this lasts a long time. Because it's Elastec, you can put it on your hook, you can catch a ton of fish on this thing, and it never goes bad. It's also ultra buoyant. So if you're looking for a great Ned rig plastic, the TRD ticklers is a phenomenal bait. It's really, really finesse application, but you can catch a lot of really big fish doing this. I've done this in my past videos, which you guys can go check out. From a kayak, I fished a TRD. I fished it on beds. I fished it during the summer and caught a bunch of big fish. This is a phenomenal bait that catches fish all year long, and it's something that I always have rigged up. The TRD ticklers is probably my favorite Ned rig plastic that's currently on the market. And some of the colors that I would recommend are green pumpkin, the deal, Drew's Craw, which is probably my all-time favorite Z-Man color. It's basically a crawfish style color or a good perch imitator. Basically a green pumpkin back, a whitish belly with a little bit of black and green and gold flake. Looks like a bunch of different forage that smallmouth feed on. So those are my three favorite colors: green pumpkin, the deal, or Drew's Craw in that Z-Man TRD ticklers. So those three soft plastics, a flatworm, a hitworm, and a Z-Man TRD ticklers are gonna be my most recommended soft plastic baits to ask for Christmas. Now, as we move into some hard baits, the first category that I wanna talk about is jig fishing. And this is something you guys typically see me do a lot of in the springtime. This is something when I fish those inland bodies of water that is really, really successful, especially for smallmouth bass. And I know a lot of you guys fish rivers and inland style bodies of water all the time. You're not fishing the Great Lakes. You're not fishing these expansive giant bodies of water, and a jig is a great way to catch them, in particular a swim jig. This is one of my favorite techniques in the spring because I can cover water with it, I can skip boat docks, I can fish it down the shore and catch a lot of fish when those inland smallies are pushed up shallow, kind of getting ready to do the spawn thing. A swim jig is a great way to cover water and get a lot of bites. Unfortunately, this year I didn't get to do it quite as much as I normally would have considering some of the dams broke around the house, but a swim jig is a really, really phenomenal technique that catches a lot of big fish. Now, there's a couple colors that I would recommend, and these are personally custom made swim jigs. I poured these at my house, but something like a June bug color or a black and blue color is gonna work great in off color water. So those dirtier water situations, a black and blue or a June bug is gonna look great. Imitates a variety of different forage silhouettes in that dirty water. It's gonna look like your bluegill. It's gonna look like your standard sort of bait fish profile, your bluegill, your sunfish, your panfish that are pushed up, spawning around the docks, or your brown with a little bit of orange, your crawfish style of color. These are the two colors that I predominantly throw, or I guess only throw. And so these are the ones that I'm gonna recommend for those northern guys. Now, if you are fishing around like the Mississippi River, you're fishing a little bit south, you're fishing Pickwick, Gunnersville, some of those southern reservoirs, you might wanna go with a white swim jig, something visual, something that looks like a shad. But for me, these are the two colors that I would recommend, a June bug or black and blue, and then some sort of craw imitation color. I would look for a 3/8 or a 1/2 ounce swim jig. Those are the two sizes that I throw in these two colors. Now, moving on to the hard baits, we're gonna start to talk about lipless crankbaits. I'm kind of walking through the seasons here. A lipless crankbait is a bait that I always have a ton of success on in the spring, and there's a lot of great lipless crankbaits on the market, from the Bill Lewis Rattle Trap to the Strike King Red Eye Shad, the Berkeley War Pig, but these are two of my favorites. Now, these are both a little bit higher end, so if you're looking for something that is a lower price point, I would recommend looking at the Rattle Trap, the Bill Lewis Rattle Trap in the 1/2 ounce size, or the Berkeley War Pig. Both of those are gonna be great, more affordable lipless crankbait models. So the first one I wanted to talk about, and probably my all-time favorite lipless crankbait, is the Lucky Craft LV500. This one has been beat up. It's been thrown and thrown and thrown and caught a ton of big fish for me. This LV500 is a 3/4 ounce lipless crankbait that's awesome for smallmouth because you can cast it out, let it sink to bottom, and fish it slowly along the bottom in the springtime, get a lot of big bites. So an LV500 in a ghost minnow color, in a craw pattern, or in just some really natural colors. A smallmouth bass pattern is also really phenomenal in the LV500. Those natural colors are what I'm aiming for in the springtime in the LV. So ghost minnow, smallmouth bass, or some sort of craw pattern, just kind of like those really natural colors are what I'm gonna be aiming for with the LV500. The other lipless crankbait that I've had a ton of success on over the past 3 or 4 years is the Duo Realis G-Fix 68. This is a really, really heavy, super thin lipless crankbait, and that means I'm gonna be able to fish this and keep this on bottom really effectively. This is a great bait for Lake St. Clair. It's a great bait for those bigger bodies of water where you're looking to keep that bait in deep water on the bottom longer. When a lot of guys are fishing blade baits, this is a great alternative. So this color here is one of my favorites. It's called Tule Perch or Tule Perch. There are some other really, really good colors, but if you're just looking for one, look for the Duo Realis 68 Vibration lipless crankbait, and you're not gonna go wrong with the Tule Perch color. Continuing on in the hard bait lineup is the Duo Realis SP100 jerk bait. Now this color here, this bait here, has caught tons and tons of fish. I don't know if you guys can see it. There's teeth marks, there's hook marks. I bent the hooks back, I've changed them out. This bait here caught me so many fish, and for years and years I was a 3-hook jerkbait guy, but this bait changed my mind. This is a bait that just flat out catches fish, catches big ones, and catches a ton of them. So the Duo Realis 100 SP jerkbait in the AM edge color is my all-time favorite shallow diving jerkbait. I like some deeper divers, but in the shallow diving range, this is the jerkbait that I'm gonna be picking up. The colors that I would recommend, obviously the AM Edge color, my all-time favorite. There are also some more natural colors with green backs and translucent sides that look like your emerald shiners, but really just kind of go with the natural colors and then throw in like an AM Edge or throw in the one with the pink back and the white belly. I don't get too crazy. I know there's some of those guys that get really specific on jerkbait colors. I fish a flashy one, I fish a opaque or whitish side one, and I fish a translucent jerkbait. Those are the three styles of jerkbaits that I throw. Pick out the colors you like, tell your mom that, or spouse or whoever, that's the color you want, but really can't go wrong with that 100SP fishing in shallow water situations. Now we're gonna move on to one of my favorite techniques ever, and that is medium diving crankbaits. Medium diving cranking is one of my favorite things to do to catch giant smallmouth bass in the spring, in the fall, in the summer on St. Clair when those fish push into like that 15-foot range. A medium diving crankbait is one of the best ways to catch them. And this is a bait that I've caught a ton of fish on this year. This is the Berkeley Dredger 14.5. This dives down to about 15 or 16 foot of water. 14 on 12 pound test, you can get it to go deeper, but the 14.5 is a phenomenal medium diving crankbait. The reason I like this is it dives really fast. It's got a metal bead in the lip, which helps it get down to depth and stay there, but it's a smaller profile bait. When I'm looking for a smallmouth style medium diving crankbait, I want a smaller profile, so the 14.5 is a perfect bait. Another really good size is the 10.5, dives around that 8.5 to 12 foot range. So the 10.5 or the 14.5 are the baits that I'm gonna be recommending for a medium diving crankbait. One of my all-time favorite colors is this yellow perch color. And the reason I like that is obviously because it looks just like a yellow perch. It really, really looks like a yellow perch. It's in the new HD True Color lineup. So that yellow perch 10.5 or 14.5 dredger is a phenomenal color. Another really good color that's more of a shad imitator is this honey shad. What I like about this, you have those white or goldish sides, a little bit of black on the back, some yellow chartreuse mixed in there. It's a really, really good color. Catches a lot of big fish. The Berkeley Dredger 10.5 and 14.5 is a phenomenal bait to ask for. Mid price range, lower price range, and it's gonna catch you a lot of fish. Another crankbait in that medium diving range that I really, really like for those crankbait fans looking for something a little bit more sneaky is this OSP Blitz EXDR. They also have the Blitz Max DR. Both are similar in shape and similar in diving depth, but this Blitz EXDR is a small body crankbait that dives to around 10 or 12 foot of water. It's a phenomenal crankbait. It's really come onto the scene over the past 2 years, and it is a bait that if you don't have in your lineup, I would recommend checking it out, especially if you love medium diving cranking. What I like about this is how small this bait is. It comes in a ton of different colors. It's a great bait, and I actually have a video out where Ron and I went out and smashed a bunch of giant fish, and this is one of the crankbaits that I was throwing in that video. So the OSP Blitz EXDR is a crankbait that I would recommend for you higher end crankbait fans, the guys that really, really love to throw a crankbait. This is a great bait to have in your arsenal. The colors that I would recommend is sort of along that same line as that dredger. Sort of those natural perch bait fish colors, maybe your vanilla chartreuse like I have here, where you have that chartreuse blackish back, your white sides, something that looks like the shad, something for that little bit dirtier water situation, or a color called Jinrin, or some of these supernatural translucent with green back style baits work phenomenal in super clean water. So that OSP Blitz EXDR is one of my top recommended crankbaits for you higher end or crankbait fanatics. So another crankbait that has really come onto the scene in the last year is the Berkeley Fritside. This was the talk of the Bassmaster Classic. This is the bait John Cox was throwing to win down on Sam Rayburn this spring. It's a phenomenal bait that has flat sides, which means it's gonna be a perfect cold water crankbait. Now this here is a 7 foot diving model. They have a 5 foot diving model and a 9 foot diver. But the all around one that I'm gonna tie on a bunch in the springtime is the 7 foot diver. It has a coffin bill, so it does dive, but because it's squared off, it's not gonna hang up that much. It's still gonna deflect and come through cover really effectively. And because it has those flat sides, it's gonna be a great cold water crankbait. This is gonna be that springtime crankbait, that late fall crankbait when you're looking for something with a really tight wiggle and tight shimmy for those giant smallmouth that are up shallow and getting ready to start to do the dirty. This Berkeley Fritside is gonna be a great bait. kind of keep in mind those same sort of colors, your crawfish colors, your chartreuses, your reds, maybe a little bit of those whites. Springtime, you're typically fishing dirtier water situations, so something that stands out against that dirtier water is going to be a really, really effective technique and color. And then as you get later in the year, the water cleans up. In the fall, it cleans up again. You want to go with those whites, those translucents. So can't go wrong really with any color. Just match your forage. If you're looking for a springtime crankbait, a little bit brighter, bolder colors, fall time crankbait, some of those more natural colors are going to be the bait to go with. Now, one more thing before we dive into the accessories that I would recommend are a couple of rods. Now, these are higher end rods. These are going to run you a little bit more money, but if you have a budget to spend or you have a higher end gift that you need to get for someone, this is something that I would absolutely recommend. This rod has been thrown and thrown and thrown. I fished it all season long from March till now. I'll probably throw it when I go out tomorrow. Is the TFO Tactical Glass Bass Cranking Rod. This is a crank bait designed rod. This is a composite rod, 60% carbon fiber, 40% glass, so you maintain that sensitivity of the carbon fiber. It's still light, but it does have that slow action that you guys need when you're throwing a crankbait or a lipless crankbait or a chatterbait. It's a phenomenal rod for all of those techniques. This is a 7.4 medium heavy. If you're looking for a tactical glass crankbait rod and you don't know which model to get, the 7.4 medium heavy is the model that I would recommend basically all around. This is your all around crankbait setup. You can throw lipless, you can throw chatterbaits, you can throw deep divers, medium divers, pretty much any technique you can throw on the 7.4 medium heavy tactical glass cranking rod. Now, I don't know if it's gonna be coming in the tactical elite, but I know for sure they're gonna be having it in that tactical model, which runs around that $159 mark. So for a super premium rod for $159, you can get one of the best crankbait and chatterbait rods on the market. So if you're in the market for a brand new rod, that's the one that I would recommend you guys checking out. Now we're gonna move into some accessories and some things, maybe like stocking stuffers that you guys need that are smaller items that you guys can just buy on a whim for someone that you know is a fisherman in your life. Now the first thing, super, super simple, is a nice pair of scissors. I believe I got these at Walmart. They're Cuda brand. They're $5 scissors. They cut braid, they cut floral, they cut a variety of different things. Super small, they're cheap, they're easy. I toss them in the bottom of my boat and I never lose them, but they cut and they cut and they cut, which is what I want in a pair of scissors, and they don't rust out. So that Cuda brand scissors, $5.99, I believe you can get them at Walmart, is a great thing to put in someone's stocking or if you just need a small gift for someone. Another thing that I would recommend is a good pair of split ring pliers. These are Texas Instruments split ring pliers. My buddy Durds is the one that turned me onto these, but these are the best pair of split ring pliers that I've ever used. They have a little notch right there, and that makes changing your split ring super, super easy. The orange handle ones are the ones you want to get. And all of this stuff will be linked down in the description below. So if you're just looking for this model, this pair of split ring pliers, I do believe it runs around $20, but it is a phenomenal pair of split ring pliers. So if you're looking for a good pair, that's a pair that I would recommend. Now, another thing that you guys see me use and wear in all of my videos are these gloves. I'm not affiliated with or sponsored by Fish Monkey, but these are something that I cannot be on the water without. So having that compression on my hands really, really helps. It also helps prevent cuts and nicks on your hand that'll get you off the water early. And they're sunproof and UPF proof. So these have been through the ringer. I've had these, I believe, 2 or 3 years. They've lasted a long time. They keep that compression on your hands, which is gonna keep you guys fishing longer. It's gonna keep you, your hands nick and cut free and keep you out there for a lot longer than if you're not wearing gloves. So those Fish Monkey sun gloves are the ones that I would recommend. They're phenomenal. I've tried a bunch of different brands and those are the best ones that I found. So this next product might kind of catch you guys off guard, but it is 5-Hour Energy. And this is a product that I always have in the boat with me. It's something that I always use and basically kind of gets me back to that 100% in the middle of the day. When I've been out there a long time, it's cold, it's nasty, maybe I'm tired, it's been tough, it's been a grinder. I drink 5-Hour Energy, kind of get back to it, get back to myself to keep fishing and going throughout the day. It's a great product. You can toss in someone's stocking. Really, really easy. You can find it just about anywhere, but 5-Hour Energy is a phenomenal product. That's the extra strength. They have the regular strength. They have the tea versions. They have a bunch of different flavors, a bunch of different styles that you guys can check out. And if you're looking to get 20% off your 5-Hour Energy order, You can go to 5hourenergy.com, use code BEN. It'll get you 20% off your order of 5-Hour Energy. And this last product is something that I've used for years and years. It's for those tackle fanatics, those guys that really want to customize their baits. They want to spend the time to make their baits, save some money, and customize the components that go in them. It is some Do It Molds hard bait lead molds. These are what I've used for years and years to kind of make my own lures, make my own jigs, make the things that I use when I'm out there on the water. Now there's two different things that I'm going to talk about, and the first is the Midwest Finesse mold. This one has been used so much. For those of you guys that are smallmouth fishermen, you know how powerful a Ned rig can be, and the Midwest Finesse mold is your Ned rig head. This is the one designed, tried, true, and tested for fishing a Ned rig. You can customize all your components. Put a really high quality hook in there. You can powder coat your heads so they don't have all the paint knocked off them the second time you throw them. It's just a phenomenal mold that I believe in and use a lot. So the Midwest Finesse assorted size Ned rig mold is the one that I would recommend if you're looking for an awesome all-around mold that you can use all the time. This is the one that I would recommend. Now the hook that I use in this is a Gamagatsu 111 size 1/0 or 2/0 hook. The reason I like that is it's stout. It doesn't bend out easily, but it's really, really sharp. And that's what I'm looking for. I don't want to set the hook and come back with a straight shank. I want a high quality hook in there because that is the first point between me and the fish, is that hook. So I want good hook penetration. I want it to handle those big, big smallmouth bass. And so when I'm looking for a Ned rig, I'm looking for a good hook, a good head, a good bait keeper. And this is the mold that will do all of those things for you. So the Midwest Finesse mold is the one that I would recommend if you're just looking for a mold for your Ned rigs. This next mold is a little bit more specialty, but it has grown on me and become one of my all-time favorite Do It molds, lead jig molds, and this is the Shake It mold. What this is a versatile ball head jig mold, and the reason I like this is because you can use a 60 degree hook, which is that forward tilting hook, like this right here, or you can use a 90 degree hook, so a vertical hook. And this is gonna work better for your swim baits. Those baits that you wanna keep more horizontal in the water column, that 90 degree hook is gonna work better. Your 60 degree hook is gonna be what I use for my tube heads and for those swim baits when I wanna creep them along bottom. So it's a super versatile mold. You can either use your 60 degree hook or your 90 degree hook. Your 90 degree is a vertical line tie, which means up and down. And your horizontal is in that 60 degree, which means side to side. So the reason this is better for crawling along the bottom is that horizontal line tie won't get hung up quite as bad. When you're dragging along bottom, it tends to crawl over cover a little bit more easily, but it keeps that bait a little bit more nose facing, a little bit more tilted down. The 90 degree hook keeps that bait a little bit more level, more horizontal, but when you're coming through cover, it's gonna wanna dig a little bit more. So it's more for open water situations up in the water column for baits like that, like swim baits. So the Do It mold, Shake It jig mold is super, super versatile. It's from 3/8 of an ounce all the way down to 1/8 of an ounce. Just a really phenomenal mold. If you're looking for a swim bait mold or a tube jig mold, this is the one that I would recommend, the Do It mold, Shake It mold. Now, like I said, all of these products will be linked down in the description for you guys. And I hope this gives you guys some ideas of what to ask for Christmas or what to buy for the fishermen in your life. Now, if there are any questions or comments on any of these products, hit me up in the comment section below. If you guys don't watch another one of my videos before Christmas, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas, a Happy Holidays, and I hope you guys spend some awesome time with your family and stay safe during this crazy year. But again, my name is Benjamin Nowak. If you're not already, please do me a huge favor, hit that subscribe button down below. And as always, thank you, take care, tight lines, God bless. Pursue your passion.